I'll be gone till November, then I'll be right back with the heat. If it ain't that, I'ma probably make it rain. Same time, same place, every year. By the liquor store and a butchery. I ain't making rules, but homie, here's a breeze. I'm nice like summer, single swan. I'm nice like summer, single swan. So I'm nice like summer, single swan. I'm nice like rain now, rain now. I'm nice like. Hey, my people, it's just another sequel of December nice time. Like another take up in a ya. Then I collide a sip until manana till the sun up. Food side playing food, show this Jew, and I act the fool. She gon' learn it. Hey, let this headmaster the school on the well. I've told her I got the fireworks, I'm Walt Disney. Let me a 50. I need a bag of that sticky, icky, I'm shifty. Like levels acting quickly, chicks talking about. Like we're from a lot. We've been party hard, straightforward guy. I got Papa Mas, fly once, acting like Hana Moha. Times where we reunite. On these newest strikes, chill and reminisce where we talk about achievements. One thing we agree on, everything is different. It's a mass simulation. If it's a part of the system, whatever, whatever, suicide, but I'm not a talking. Like summer, single swan. So I'm nice like summer, single swan. I'm nice like summer, single swan. I'm nice like right now, I'm nice like. And I'll be gone to November, and I'll be right back with the hit. If it ain't that, I'ma probably make it rain. Same time, same place, every year. By the liquor store and a butchery. I ain't making rules, but homie, it's free. And baby, before Kija Kuku, Pitu Takwala, Chibu, Kuki, Timmy, Pony, Makuku, before Kitsa, Pira, Huku, Moto, Haka, Puku, Puku, check the rights back, back to school, Rila, Vitsika, Ruku, Bushaba, Papa, Kasuku. I was told you only get paid, I was better suit. What if we try to Kapuku, Yala, Fuku, adversity, we want us to Puku, Lemon versus Solo, Bakaru, two bits, and Sun, Duku, and you're so food, and you tell them no can do. Wanna tell you this and that, no fight, but I'm over that subject, yo. I just wanna do me, bro. And I'll be gone to November. Then I'll be right back with the heat. If it ain't that, I'ma probably make it rain. Same time, same place, every year. By the liquor store and in butchery. I ain't make the rules, but homie, here's a breeze. I'm nice like summer, summer swan. Yeah, I'm nice like summer, summer sun, I'm nice like summer, summer sun, I'm nice like, nice, nice, I'm nice.
Let's keep on. I don't see man, but I want to let it let us feel like my kid and I go tell it to let you turn. Now, the first ask, who power to what's up with Tokyo Night? Except let us keep on. I don't see man, but I want to let it let us feel like my kid and I go tell it to let you turn. Now, the first ask, who power to what's up with Tokyo Night? Hold up. Who tells you how to watch from what you dream? What's a coupon? Can I get a coupon on the road? Slow searching, what's in hand to an upper hand? Knife fishing on, we do that dance with a rubber band. I make the nyoko colorful, what is the money to make the man? Grown man kid, rocking my grandpa's soul. Generational hand-me-down shoes. Just wanna know if there's a coming round of dad dudes. I'm the nigga she buy the tools. Trying to make the goddamn bands dance like fools. Sickly dickin' just to live. Hey, Seuss with the juice. You stretch food, one line, maybe you a noose. Even still the lines, neighborhood, watch him jacket. Mob justice, bum sweater, bum clapping. You don't for your darkness, come up, bum ratty. Call him trash, can
you live it out? This is your radio.
This is Youth with your host, Angela Kudua. Catch us every day, 11 to 12.
The views and opinions expressed on this show are those of the authors and do not necessarily reflect the official policy or position of the DAO Academy. Any content provided by bloggers or authors are of their opinion and are not intended to malign any religion, ethnic group, club, organization, company, individual, or anyone or anything.
The radio station you can't live without. This is your radio.
The views and
hey, what's up? How you doing?
I'm great, thanks. And yourself?
I'm alive and well.
I see.
I'm good. I'm taking over the reins today.
See you.
Yeah, my mama gave me a little bit of a little spin on the show today. I hope you don't mind that.
No, I don't mind at all.
How's your weekend?
Oh, it was fine.
Awesome. So this is the Eddy M Drive.
Wow.
And we are here at the Teleradio station out in Pachuti. We are going to be having a show between 8 and 9 a.m. We're going to talk about everything with health. I do help. And if you're outside the country, please remember to add the +267, which is a code. Summer is in for spawning. You know, even so, it's really, I love this song because it reminds me of like, it's got a good vibe to it.
So this is the song.
Yeah.
I know it. I don't know what it's called.
So summer's kind of fun. It sounds like, it reminds me of like, remember summertime?
Yeah.
Summertime. Okay. Summer.
I'll be gone to November.
You're right.
Then I'll be right back with the heat. If it ain't that, I'ma probably make it rain. Same time, same place, every year. By the liquor store in a Portuguese. I ain't make the rules, but homie, it's breeze. I'm nice like summer sun.
Yeah.
I'm nice like summer sun.
I'm imagining it right now in my head.
So I'm nice like summer sun.
Who knows? Yeah.
I'm nice like I'm nice like
the nice things. Yeah, I get it, man.
Neighbor people,
it.
It's just another sequel of December nice time. Making nothing to come in a yarn. Doing a colada, sipping to my yarn until the sun up. Pool style, playing pool, show this dude, and act the fool. She gonna learn it. Took this headmaster to school on the bell. I told her, I got the fireworks, I'm Walt Disney. Love me a 50. I need a bag of that sticky, icky, I'm shifty. Let that was sticking quickly. Shit, talking about, stuck up from a lot. We've been party hard, straight.
Well, I
want
to ask you, what did you have for breakfast?
Fly once, sticking like Hana. Times where we
wow.
We talk about achievements. One thing we agree on, everything is different. It's a nice.
But I had a shake this morning. That's really how. Ideally, that's how I start, right?
Like summer.
Ideally, and then I'll have like maybe a piece of bread,
nice like summer
bacon, an egg, coupled with like coffee or tea.
I'm nice like summer.
What did you have on?
What did I have for breakfast? I don't eat breakfast.
I mean, nice. We'll have breakfast.
No, I won't have it. I'm waiting for lunch.
You're waiting for lunch, yeah.
Yeah.
I know you're about big things. All right, take it away, Eddy. What do you have for us?
So today I have health tips on how to take care of your eyes. Yes. I've realized that most people just, you know, rub their eyes. You're not supposed to rub your eyes with your hands, because your hands are dirty. You touch everything and you will forget. Trust me, you will say, I'll wash my hands, but you will forget to wash your hands. So first thing, make sure that you know your family's medical history.
Uh-huh.
You know, just like I got to wear glasses just because of my family history.
Yeah.
But I was taking care of my eyes.
So I think my wife right now, she's got horrible eyes. Yeah, it's pretty terrible. She tells me, she's like, hey man, my eyes are horrible. So I take my glasses off, I can't see the thing. But she still makes sure that she takes care of her eyes regardless. So she makes sure, like, you know, she checks the condition regularly and she eats right and everything. So I think, like you said correctly, know your blood type, know your genetics, know what you're predisposed to, and then try and keep watch on that. Like, like I'm predisposed to things like diabetes and obesity, right? So I just make sure that I watch my weight, I listen to my body, when my body tells me, oh, it's time to make a change. What else do you have?
Thank you for saying the third point.
Yeah.
You said it. I don't know. Yeah, you said it, like maintaining your weight and all that. You said it, yes.
Oh, cool. Awesome.
I like you. I'll invite you on my big question sometime.
It will be a pleasure.
So the other point is avoid smoking. Smoking, we all know that it's bad for lungs, but it's also bad for your eyes. That's why you can also see that people have brownish stuff on their eyes and all that. So, no, do you smoke?
Well,
I'm answered.
What? No, I have to explain myself.
What are you explaining? I just asked that question. I want yes or no. And then you go on some
technically,
answer.
Technically.
What are you saying?
Technically, I don't.
Wow.
That's what I'm saying. Okay, but keep
going. All right.
All right, cool.
Okay, and then the other point, you should know other risk factors that involve you not, like, for example, like I said, always make sure that you don't touch your eyes. Uh-huh. You know, some people are just always going to, I know your eye can itch, but you don't have to use your hands. You just open your eyes and put them in a bottle of water to avoid that irritation. It's difficult to open your eyes, but eventually the water will get in. So that's regarded as baby health. I'm actually tired. It's fun.
I rub my eyes, right?
Going hard in the pain, I feel like no whiskey.
You see? Like it doesn't help.
Yeah.
I tell myself the same thing. You start rubbing. After a few days of doing that,
and the water issue is great. It works. The moment you are done and then you wipe your face, that's it. You won't eat for the rest of the day unless maybe you ate something that you're allergic to or whatnot. But I highly recommend it.
Anything else?
No. That is all that I
have. That is all that you have for us. All right, guys. In any case,
TDA,
the view.
We are here with TDA, and one of the symptoms. A lot of people kind of the week I was convinced that COVID, my eyes were I'm not sure. I had it, but I might be wrong.
You know? I was in that right now, or?
Huh?
Oh. I was
right now. This was like a year ago.
All right.
Like last year. I'm talking about last year. So, guys, also remember that one of the symptoms of COVID is like your eyes swelling up. Don't, especially when it's uncharacteristic. You know, when you know you have good eyes, you take care of your eyes, and you swell up, you must also go to the doctor. All right, cool. Let's pay some bills. Let's see what we have coming up for the rest of the week.
The views and opinions expressed on this show are those of the authors and do not necessarily reflect the official policy or position of the DAO Academy. Any content provided by bloggers or authors are of their opinion and are not intended to malign any religion, ethnic group, club, organization, company, individual, or anyone or anything.
The radio station you can't live without. This is your radio.
This is Anis Musopelo.
And
this is on the Tech Report from Monday to Friday at 12 p.m. to 1 p.m.
rain.
I like winter.
I'm like, nah. Summers, please bring back summers.
Hey, my people.
Why? So that we can get out the house, have some fun.
But then it tends to get extremely hot.
What is extremely hot? What does that even mean? What does extremely hot mean?
Very hot. Like very, 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 very hot.
No, there's no such thing as very hot. There's no such thing as too hot. It's either hot or it's cold.
But then last week we talked about high temperatures in Botswana, you remember?
Yes, we did. I remember.
Yes, that's very, very hot.
Okay. Now, yes. So
I'm nice like summer.
What do you like about winter?
When it's cold, you can at least put like something on.
So you want to look like a penguin if you like.
It's better than to feel hot, yet you're not like wearing anything.
You should see me. I look like a penguin. Like I'm always like this.
You should. You should ask Mr. Ian.
No, Mr. Ian is
never looks like a penguin.
He's built for another weather. I think this that kid is a thick coat somewhere in there. Yeah. There's a thick coat in there, I'm telling you. In any case, and before we go to the news, let's just make sure we pay some bills.
Views and opinions expressed on this show are those of the authors and do not necessarily reflect the official policy or position of the DAO Academy. Any content provided by bloggers or authors are of their opinion and are not intended to malign any religion, ethnic group, club, organization, company, individual, or anyone or anything.
The radio station you can't live without. This is your radio.
Time for news. RTDA Teleradio, straight out of Mercury.
The radio station you can't live without. This is your radio. Number one local station.
The new brand of radio. Good morning and thank you for tuning in to the DAO Academy Teleradio News. It is Monday the 21st of June and I hope it is not too late to say Happy Father's Day to our fathers in the studio.
Thank you.
Yes, I'm Amantla Haidzewi, so here are your headlines this morning. New oil field in African wilderness threatens life of 130,000 elephants. Bertukan Mideska becomes Ethiopia's electoral board chairperson. Ugandan tests positive for COVID-19 in Japan, Tokyo 2021 Olympics. And lastly, Usain Bolt welcomes newborn twin sons Thunder and Saint Leo. Those were our headlines this morning. Tune back in at 9 o'clock for our full news in detail.
The views and opinions expressed on this show are those of the authors and do not necessarily reflect the official policy or position of the DAO Academy. Any content provided by bloggers or authors are of their opinion and are not intended to malign any religion, ethnic group, club, organization, company, individual, or anyone or anything.
The radio station you can't live without. This is your radio.
Yo, what up, what up? This is your boy, Eddy. Join us every Friday on the TDA Teleradio station for Thank God It's Friday.
Time for sports on TDA Teleradio, straight out of Madrid.
The radio station you can't live without. This is your radio.
Good morning. I am Demi Max with today's sports update. On Saturday, we had Hungary and France and they drew 1-1. Afiola scored at 45 plus 2 minutes and Griezmann finishing up close range after Mbappe had held up Hugo Lloris' long kick upfield. Portugal lost 2-4 to Germany. Two own goals in four first half minutes helped rejuvenated Germany to a crucial 4-2 comeback, thrashing off Portugal in sweltering hot Euro 2020 Group F blockbuster in Munich. Cristiano Ronaldo tapping in his 107th international goal and first against Germany after good work from Bernardo Silva and Diogo Jota. The game then filled on its head with when Portugal defenders Ruben Dias and Rafael Guerreiro each turned the ball into their own net. Kai Havertz at 51 minutes converting from close range to become their youngest ever scorer at Euro before Ruben Gosens, who had put in crosses for two of the earlier goals, nodded in free header at back port of the hour. There was hope for Portugal when an unmarked Ronaldo set up Jota at 67 minutes to pull one back and Renato Sanchez crashed against Warwick Wood. And yesterday, Italy won 1-0 to Wales. 10-man Wales sealed second spot in Group A and a place in the last 16 of Euro 2020 despite losing 1-0 to a much-changed Italy in Rome. Ethan straight red card on 55 minutes had sparked fierce Switzerland, who beat Turkey 3-1, could come up with the goal difference swing they needed to send Wales to the uncertainty of third place qualifying spot. But Rob Page's side battled hard in the heat of the Italian capital to set up a knockout clash with the runners of Group B in Amsterdam at 5 p.m. next Saturday. Matteo Pessina had given Italy a deserved lead and Federico Benedeschi hit the woodwork with a free kick just after halftime as Roberto's team showed their strength and depth. Although Gareth Bale should have claimed a famous draw from his side, he wastefully volleyed over the late on. Wales supporters will hope their captain, who missed a penalty in their last match, is sharper next weekend, while Italy have now been beaten in 30 games. And Spain drew to Portland. Gerard Moreno missed penalty, condemned Spain to a frustrating second draw of Euro 2020 as Robert Lewandowski and Poland 1-1 draw in Seville. Morata got Spain off the perfect start with opener on 25 minutes. Lewandowski introduced himself in the tournament in style with an exquisite header. Today's fixtures are North Macedonia taking on Netherlands at 5 o'clock, Ukraine taking on Austria at 5 o'clock, Finland and Belgium at 8 o'clock, Russia and Denmark at 8 o'clock as well. Now, moving on to tennis, we have Norrie beaten in Berrettini's Queen Club final. The British number two is the only player to have taken a set of Berrettini's during the Italian run to the title, but an ultimately break of serve at 4-3 in the final set proved to be his undoing. Berrettini becomes the first player to win the Queen's Club title on debut since Boris Becker did so in 1985. And he is the first Italian to win the tournament. He was just too good for me today and better than me on big points, Norrie said on court after losing the final. All credit to Matteo and his team. It's great. It's been great, a great week for them. That was it.
That right there was the sports news. Quick on the news, like I have a question.
Yes.
So how do you, I'm nice, like you like said, there's a guy, there's a Ugandan athlete who caught the COVID out in the games, nice, like right?
Yeah.
Do you believe like our protocols, like you know, are good enough in terms of, you know, temperature, because I go to the checks at temperature and
sometimes.
That's all we're doing, right?
Yep.
Do you think we're doing a good job? Or do you think like we need to have more symptoms in terms of checks?
We're not doing good, but I don't know what we need to do in order to get.
Demi, are you gonna watch the games today?
Of course, why not?
So what's you? I haven't been watching these games. So which team are you supporting?
I'm with Germany.
You're with Germany.
Yes.
That's a safe. We call that a safe bet. Wow. That's a safe bet. Like you have to go with like one of these. Underrated team, like
no,
Poland,
oh, like no. I've been supporting Germany ever since.
Oh, so like watching the
no,
I'm with you. I haven't really been watching. I think I'll start watching from quarterfinals.
The final, I'll watch the final.
From the final,
yes,
yeah, because these group stages, I think I don't know. I feel like. It's like guys are not really there.
But they're actually there.
But no. They're not really there.
They're not really there.
Wow. No.
Feel the compared to the final, that's when people are really there. Wow. Yeah.
Okay, all right. Hey guys, thank you so much for stopping by. That was the music brief and the sports update. We are here on EMP Drive with Eddy, and we're going to be hanging out with someone very, very, very soon. I think we're going to be late. I don't know. But before we do that, let us remember that
the views and opinions expressed on this show are those of the authors and do not necessarily reflect the official policy or position of the DAO Academy. Any content provided by bloggers or authors are of their opinion and are not intended to malign any religion, ethnic group, club, organization, company, individual, or anyone or anything.
The radio station you can't live without. This is your radio.
The best songs on the radio. This is my only favorite station.
Egena gas puja nagi shapila mashankura kinsi zedi toho dage twage zedi tapura bana baba mpona karibuche baika pola zaka zame ma ajita bading kapola jita bakana bariki pindi dropa waya put mumizi bari sande yasho we don't get old we get lolo skarada wiza dropa lolo mwana kuma lefati we basto faka sunroof izi njasa kana bari woof woof Convoy Naritalaga Choi wanna cover the call spring can S if I get the BBS a true pantu and never get vega.
I know nothing about that, but all I know is my good friend Tavos produced the song. Tavos is a rapper producer based in Kasane and he's really, really, really talented. How you guys doing today?
I'm all right.
I'm good.
I'm living though.
Do you need a minute to like gather yourselves, get in the mood?
I have a headache right now, but otherwise I'm good.
Did you drink water yesterday?
Yes, I did. Yesterday? Yes, I did.
And this morning?
No.
Nah. First thing you do when you wake up in the morning, start with a small cup. Have a small cup of water, and then start your day.
We got small cups.
Yeah, we got small cups.
We got small cups.
You got them?
We got them.
Exactly. So, you know, start your day with a small cup at home, not here. At home. Ne? Because here, you've already gone through like a process of your body, you know, getting into it. And if you don't have fuel, then you're going to struggle.
Yeah.
Amanda, what's up?
I'm just good.
You're just good. Yeah. That's what I'm talking about.
Must be nice.
So what do we have today? What do you guys have for us today? Like what's happening? What's popping? What's going on?
I'm profiling my daddy.
Oh, profile. Yesterday was Father's Day. So guys,
you said your daddy? Sort of, yes.
So that's like you want those brownie points, ne? Anyway, I'm not gonna say anything. Go ahead, guys. I'm just here to have some fun and ask some questions. So take it away whenever you're ready.
Okay, I'm ready right now. I'm ready. So today I'm profiling Khaled Muhammad Khaled.
DJ Khaled.
Yes.
All right.
Professionally known as DJ Khaled. Yeah, he's an American DJ. A record producer, a songwriter, and a media personality. Born on the 26th of November, 1975 in New Orleans. Yes. That is my DJ for today.
That's all? That's all you have for Khaled?
Well, that's the what you call this? What's this?
Okay, I'm gonna add one more. Khaled started out as a member of a group called Terror Squad
with
legendary rapper Big Punisher and Fat Joe. You know Fat Joe? What's love?
I can see. Yes. Mm-hmm. Terror Squad, Ace Hood, Birdman, Fat Joe. Well,
and then
he
kind of broke off from Terror Squad and started We The Best Music. And his first act, I believe, was Ace Hood.
And that's why he always starts, We the Best.
That's right. It's from We the Best Music. And that's what is his stable.
Well, that was We the Best in 2007. And that was We the Best Forever in 2011.
Yeah, that's just Khaled being Khaled. It's the same with the best.
That's just Muhammad, man.
Khaled.
That's just Muhammad, yeah.
All right, cool. Miss Amanda, talk to me. What's going on? What's popping? What's crack-a-lacking? What's going on?
Oh, I'm here for the Youth Roundup.
The Youth Roundup. What's happening? What's going on?
So here? I have a word of advice. It's a quote. You are braver than you believe, stronger than you seem, and smarter than you think. You are braver than you believe, stronger than you seem, and smarter than you think.
Okay, that's
that carries a lot of weight. Hey, I don't know about you guys, but yeah,
it's a bit loaded because I feel like sometimes we get carried away and think we're actually smarter than we are, and we actually aren't.
No, that's not what you say. Wait, you say we are smarter than we think. This is a positive quote. You're saying the opposite.
Yeah, I'm saying it's a double-edged sword. Because sometimes if you're downtrodden, right? If you feel like you need that pickup, that works. But someone who already has a big head, and you tell them that, they're like, actually, yes, I am. And then they'll jump off a cliff thinking wings are going to grow out of them and they're going to fly. I don't know.
That's cold.
Am I am I extra?
Yes.
Oh, guys. Really? Being extra.
But I feel like you guys are saying two different things, though.
No,
like,
we're saying the same thing, but from different sides of the coin. I'm looking at it from a pessimistic side, where it's like, you know, someone who is already full of themselves, and you tell them that, their head is just going to pop. And of course, Amanda is taking it from someone who needs that encouragement so that they can feel just a little bit better about it.
Yeah.
So you have to look at both sides. A coin has two faces. Be careful. Anything else, guys?
So there's positivity and looking at the negativity.
Actually, I think there's optimism and pessimism. Because I think positive and negative are very absolutist. You know, it's like this side and that side. Whereas, you know, pessimist is like, they look at any situation from a negative side, whereas an optimist will look at the same situation but in a positive aspect. You feel me?
Sure. Why not?
Like summers in Botswana.
Like summers. You know, by the time we're done today, this song would have played, I think, 50 times. It's such a cool song. Such an optimist song. Imagine such a song coming out of heat. Imagine such a song coming out of heat. Such a cool song. In any case, you are hanging out with us. We're on the TDA Teleradio Station. This is EMP Drive with Mr. Eddy. Hashtag, what's the hashtag?
How ironic. The world is yours.
The world is yours. Why is it ironic?
We're hanging out on EMP Drive with your boy Eddy. That's just funny.
Why is that funny?
ENP Drive with your boy Eddy.
You know what I'm saying?
I don't get it. Like, it's like, or this is youth roundup with Amanda, but you're hanging with Sleep.
Yeah. You know.
In any case, we'll be right back.
Do you agree?
These messages.
The views and opinions expressed on this show are those of the authors and do not necessarily reflect the official policy or position of the DAO Academy. Any content provided by bloggers or authors are of their opinion and are not intended to malign any religion, ethnic group, club, organization, company, individual, or anyone or anything.
The radio station you can't live without. This is your radio.
Celebrating each and every staff member in our school. Join me, Slee, and Anis on TDA Village on Monday to Thursday at 5:03 to 5:04.
You can still live, I have no life. I say, we live to die, some die to live, some die, well, some live, some die, but have not lived. Some die alive, they live by dead inside. Cause through this, you can still live, but have no life.
Living and breathing, but we have no life, Lord. Give me a reason why they take our lives. They stormed the Capitol, but if it was black folks, punishment will be capital. They put a cap in you like you a damn joke. We at an all-time low. Ain't no freedom of speech. They censor us till we can't breathe. Got knees on our throats, not even freedom to leave. I hope Corona a hoax. It's been a bad couple weeks. Where did the good days go? Ain't no love on the street. All we see is police. And Lord, the people are scared, but we all gotta eat. They say the vaccine, the mark of the beast. And hunger pains from quarantine make me feel weak, huh? So they create a desert and they call it peace, huh? Perfect picture, I see the veil of Mona Lisa. Hate is a weapon, but they all got a piece, huh? But we can't share, they keep the pie out of reach, huh? They better release us of the leash, bruh.
Before we bite the hand that doesn't feed us, presidents get impeached, huh? Bad weeks, huh? Bad life, you assume from the feeders.
We live to die, some down to live, some die, well, some live, some die, but have not lived. Some die alive, they live, but dead inside. Cause truth is, you can still live, but have no life. I say, we live to die, some down to live, some die, well, some live, some die, but have not lived. Some die alive, they live, but dead inside. Cause truth is, you can still live, but have no life.
Opinions expressed on this show are those of the authors and do not necessarily reflect the official policy or position of the DAO Academy. Any content provided by bloggers or authors are of their opinion and are not intended to malign any religion, ethnic group, club, organization, company, individual, or anyone or anything.
The radio station you can't live without. This is your radio.
Catch Cop NCT on the art show every Monday, Tuesday, Thursday, and Friday at 2 p.m. Bake in a bake.
The views and
yeah, we are back.
I'll be gone in November.
Hip hop food.
No.
And I'll be right back with the heat.
I know that's the vibe, but you know,
if it ain't that, I'ma probably make it rain. Same time, same place. Every year, by the liquor store,
yeah.
Not me.
Boost, but homie, it's crazy. I'm nice like summer, some sun.
Youth is something I never want to take for granted. I just
want to. I'm nice like summer, some sun.
That's cool. Like that is
like summer, some sun.
That's meaningful.
Is it?
Yeah, it is. I mean,
so I think it's just.
Yeah, that's because you're not part of
you. I'm young. Leave me alone. I'm young.
You're not.
Can I be young, please?
No.
I'm young. I'm
how did it not touch you? If you're young, how did it not touch
me? Because I'm doing it. I'm practicing it. I am that quote.
You're living it. You
so,
see?
So if I'm the quote, then it's like, okay, that's my life already.
Yeah.
What,
so
what else is new? But let me tell you what Kurt Cobain said about young people. Kurt Cobain, famous, rest in peace, Kurt Cobain, frontman of a group called Nirvana. And he said this. He said, the duty of youth is to challenge corruption. What? I want to ask you guys, you're going to spot for 2 seconds, but we're wrapping up. What does that tell you? Like, how does that speak to you? What do you understand that to be? I'm at the
nice like the beauty of youth.
The duty.
The duty. Okay.
Is to challenge corruption.
Is to challenge corruption.
How does that speak to you?
I'll go to sleep first. It's still marinating inside.
Okay, let's not let it overcook you.
I'm just gonna see what's on my mind. No, sorry if it doesn't make sense. Usually like that. But yeah, I feel like as youth, we're like this group of everybody living is the group where we come across a lot of challenges. You get it, challenges like teenage pregnancy, peer pressure. So like we are damn, the thought just like, can you please repeat it again?
The quote is,
that happens.
The duty of youth is to challenge corruption.
Yeah, so we are the group that is facing a lot of challenges, like I said. So our duty is to see if we can actually fight those challenges. It has to do with temptations and et cetera and et cetera. I know you don't like et cetera, but yeah.
Et cetera, et cetera.
Like... And everything else.
Yes.
You mean like mental health and all that?
No, like corruption. Let's see, like,
yeah,
what
Amanda,
do teenagers
Amanda.
Usually do?
I see what you're doing there. No. What's your view? We only have about 5 minutes left. I need your view. What is your view on that quote?
Duty.
The duty. Your job, basically.
My job.
As a young person.
As a young person.
Is to fight. Corruption.
Oh, yes, is to challenge corruption.
Yes.
To fight for what's mine.
You see, now you're talking. Let's go.
That's scary.
Keep going.
To fight for what's mine.
Uh-huh.
Basically.
Yeah, no, that's
all.
That's everything.
Yeah, you know, I just needed a sentence.
Keep talking like that. Just one-liners, you know, those one-liners, write them down. That's what quotes are made of.
Okay.
Yeah.
Maybe I can run to be president.
Yes, you.
Oh,
maybe.
Please.
Oh,
please.
I will run.
There we go.
Please, dude, because I'm hungry.
Affirmation. Yeah, that's right, guys. Like, as young people, right? You guys are vibrant. Okay, you guys are vibrant. You guys have your full health. No bones are creaking. You're flexible, mentally and physically. You know what I'm saying? And you have your whole lives ahead of you. So if you start looking into, you know, what's right and what's wrong, depending on how you were brought up, your values, right? It means you can use your vibrance, you can use your strength, you can use your voice, because you have opinions as young people. You're not seasoned, you know, like when you talk, you stand by what you believe in.
Uh-huh.
And if you band together and you say, this is what we believe in, this is what we want to achieve, and this is what we know to be right, then people will listen. Because you, people always say young people are the future. You know what I'm saying? We're the past. You guys are the future. So,
but you were young.
I am young, but you know.
How are you the past?
I'm very young.
If you're young.
Don't worry. Time travel. It's called the grandfather paradox. You should look into that. So that is our job as young people. Our job is to challenge the status quo.
You said our. You said our.
Yeah. I mean, you know, the blessing of and the privilege of being my age is you fit in everywhere. You know, I could do push-ups with a 15-year-old and struggle to get down the stairs with a 70-year-old, like, all in one day.
So can I ask?
Yeah, go ahead.
Can a 21-year-old be president?
Yeah, why not?
Exactly, why not?
Why not? I mean, and I like that you're asking that question, because those are the questions we need to be asking, to say, okay, does age really matter? If you have the drive, you know, if you have the wisdom.
The EMP drive.
You know, why not?
Like summers in Botswana.
You 21?
I'm not 21.
Okay.
I'm thinking.
You're asking for a friend.
I'm 21.
No, you're not 21.
How do you know I'm not?
You don't look 21.
Ouch. My goodness. Okay, guys, I think this is where we wrap up the show. I'm about to switch these mics off for these people. And are calling me names
this was a fight.
On the TGIF Tele radio station. I'm being reminded how much my back hurts, and I can feel it right now. So I'm gonna start rounding up, and I'm start leaving. Guys, thank you so much for hanging out with me.
Like summers
awesome.
In Botswana.
Like summers in Botswana. Stay sharp. Stay cool. Don't stay cold. Warm yourselves up.
Stay out of trouble.
Coffee. Yeah, stay out of trouble. And
stay hydrated.
So that's the outro.
Yep.
EMP drive with Eddy.
EMP drive with Eddy.
The Eddy edition.
The Eddy edition.
Yeah, you could call it that. Thank you, guys. Thank you for hanging out with me. I hope you had a great morning. I know I'm not as dope as you know, as Mr. Ian
Stop. Is, stop. Don't even finish that sentence. What? Don't. No, what? Don't say that about yourself.
Okay.
That's not good.
It's good.
No.
There's a word for it.
Do not compare.
Don't say that.
There's a word for it. You know the word?
What?
There's What's a word that? For what I just did.
What's the word?
The word humility.
No, you're not being humble. You're not.
Oh, my goodness.
You're not being humble. Okay.
All right, guys. There's a new word, guys.
Yeah.
But the word for Monday is humble.
Please, dictionary. You're not being humble. That's no humility.
Okay.
Okay.
I was trying to be humble, you know, because I'm humbled that Mr. Ian found it fit to ask me to carry the show on his behalf. So as a thank you, I'm just saying, you know, I couldn't do it the way he does it. I'm just doing my best.
That's what if he did that so that you could feel
that's him.
And not
that's him. You know, we do things because we see the value in other people.
Feel exactly. He sees the value
and
in
then
you.
The reciprocity. Or as a person who's been given that responsibility because someone believes in you. The thank you give
is to be humble.
Is to be that one's gonna stay in my mind the whole day.
I wanted
to be humble. Anyway, guys, it's almost time for the news at 9, I believe, and our newscaster is here already. So let's pay a few bills and
summer's in Botswana.
You guys gotta get out of here.
Bye, guys.
Peace.
Stay humble.
Stay humble, guys.
Like summers in Botswana.
Opinions expressed on this show are those of the authors and do not necessarily reflect official policy or position of the DAO Academy. Any content provided by bloggers or authors are of their opinion and are not intended to malign any religion, ethnic group, club, organization, company, individual, or anyone or anything.
The radio station you can't live without. This is your radio.
Yeah, catch us breakfast with Andy every day from 9 a.m. to 10 a.m. with my co-host Amanda. If not your health, then who's boom?
Time for news on TDA Teleradio, straight out of Madrid.
The radio station you can't live without. This is your radio.
Number one local station.
We did the radio.
Good morning once again. Thank you for tuning back in. Here are your news in detail. Tens of thousands of African elephants are under threat from plans for a massive new oil field in one of the continent's last great wilderness. Campaigners and conservationists fear the proposed oil field stretching across Namibia and Botswana would devastate regional ecosystems and wildlife as well as local communities. According to The Guardian, the plans are the latest threat to elephants in the region, hundreds of which have died mysteriously in the past year. Scientists are trying to find the cause of the deaths, but believe they may be linked to a rising amount of toxic algae caused by global heating in their water holes. Rosemary Ellis from Global March for Rhinos and Elephants said it is incomprehensible that Reckon Africa's hunt for fossil fuels is going ahead. Fewer than 450,000 elephants survive in Africa, down from millions not so long ago. 130,000 of these have established this region as a home range, and Reckon Africa's misbegotten plans place them at direct risk. Reckon Africa, a Canadian oil and gas company listed on stock exchanges in Canada, the US, and Germany, has leased more than 34,000 kilometers of land in the Kavango Basin. Exploratory work has begun, and experts say the new oil fields could be one of the biggest of recent years. Reckon Africa estimates that the potential oil generated could be between 60 billion and 120 billion barrels and be worth billions of dollars to the regional economy. Scientists, environmentalists, and local communities say the project could jeopardize critical water supplies and threaten the Okavango Delta in Botswana, which is a huge pristine wilderness and World Heritage Site. Moving on to other news, a former political prisoner who went into exile in the U.S., Bertu Khan Medeska, is now center stage in Ethiopia as she oversees the country's first parliamentary election since Prime Minister Abiy Ahmed took office in 2018 on a pledge to end decades of authoritarian rule. According to BBC, recommending Ms. Bertukan 47 to all important posts of chairperson of the electoral board, the new premier described her as someone who would never surrender even to the government. Many agreed with that sentiment as she had built a reputation for being brave and independent-minded as a lawyer, judge, and politician. Ms. Bertukan contested the 2001 parliamentary election as an independent, but lost to the candidate of the ruling coalition, the Ethiopian People's Revolutionary Democratic Front, conceding that her defeat was due to her limited popularity rather than rigging. She then became a judge, catching the attention of the public a year later when she resisted political interference in the judiciary by ordering the release of former defense minister Sie Abraha. His arrest on corruption charges was seen as an attempt to neutralize a formidable rival of then Prime Minister Meles Zenawi. Sie's case is the visible one, but they, Ms. Bertukan and the other judges, all tried to challenge the system invisibly for a while, said a friend who spoke on condition of the anonymity. Restless for charge, Ms. Bertukan moved back into politics, playing a key role in the formation of the Coalition for Unity and Democracy to present a united front against the EPRDF in the 2005 parliamentary election, which was widely seen as the most fiercely contested poll in Ethiopia's history, with the opposition claiming that it had been robbed of victory. Looking at other news, a member of Uganda's Olympic squad has become the first to test positive for COVID-19 on arrival in Japan for the competition due to start on 23 July. According to BBC, the event was postponed last year but is now going ahead despite a fresh wave of COVID-19 cases in Japan. Uganda is also experiencing a surge in cases, which forced the government to tighten lockdown measures on Friday. The unnamed Ugandan was part of a 9-member squad who had all been fully vaccinated. The group, who included boxers, coaches, and officials, had also tested negative before leaving Uganda. However, one of them tested positive on arrival at Tokyo's Narita Airport on Saturday and was quarantined at a government-designated facility. Japanese officials were quoted by local media as saying, "The rest of the squad left by chartered bus for Osaka in Western Japan, where they are to train ahead of the games." The Ugandans were the second group of foreign athletes to arrive for training ahead of the competition, with the Australian women's softball squad arriving on the 1st of June. Foreign spectators have been banned from the Olympics, which is a decision is expected to be taken on Monday on whether to allow domestic spectators. Lastly, sprinter Usain Bolt has had twin boys named Thunderbolt and Saint Leopold. Bolt, who is 34, announced the news on Instagram on Father's Day with a lightning bolt emoji next to each of his children's names. According to BBC, the Olympic champion posted a photo of him and partner Cassie Bennett with their two boys and one-year-old daughter Olympia Lightning. The couple did not say when exactly the twins were born. Bennett also posted a photo with the baby, saying Bolt was the rock of this family and the greatest daddy to our little ones. Olympia Lightning was born in May 2020 and her name was announced publicly 2 months later. Before her birth, Bolt had kept followers updated of Bennett's pregnancy on his social media. However, neither he nor Bennett had posted about her pregnancy with the twins. Bolt, a Jamaican sprinting icon, retired from athletics in 2017 and still holds the 100-meter and 200-meter world records, making him the fastest man in history. He is also the only man to have won 300-meter Olympic titles and 23 major gold medals during his career. After leaving athletics, he tried to play professional football, but then announced he was leaving sports entirely in 2019. Bolt is not the first celebrity to use a play on words when naming children. In 2013, Kanye West and his wife Kim Kardashian West, who are currently separated, made headlines when they named their child Northwest. Musician Jermaine Jackson named his son, who is now 20-year-old, Jermajesty. And television actor Rob Morrow from 1990 series Northern Exposure named his daughter, who is now also an actor, Tomorrow. Those were our headlines this morning. Now, moving on to the COVID update, Botswana has 63,247 cases, and 58,541 have since recovered, with only 940 deaths. Those were our news in detail and our COVID-19 update. Tune back in at 10:30 for more headlines.
You know Gwyneth Paltrow and Chris Martin?
Nope.
Chris Martin is a frontman of an alternative rock group called Coldplay.
Oh, I know Coldplay.
So yeah. The front man's name is Chris Martin.
Okay.
The wife is, you've seen Iron Man? Iron Man 1, 2, 3, Avengers, Endgame.
Yeah, I know Avengers.
Endgame, okay.
Endgame.
Tony Stark's wife. Pepper Potts?
Oh, yeah, okay.
That's Gwyneth Paltrow. They have a daughter called Apple.
Apple, yeah, like the apple, the fruit.
Yep. Anyway, GT, what's coming up next? Let me know.
It's Breakfast with Angie.
Oh, Angie's coming back with more breakfast tips. But before we do that, let us remember that.
You're listening to only the best internet radio station in the world.
The best songs on the radio. This is my only favorite station. Thank you.